The Music Room, on track with Toyota.
Welcome to The Music Room on CNN.
Welcome once more to the home of global music. I'm Sasha Rionda. This week,
Britney on maturing and making music, a TMR exclusive.
Hi everyone. Once in a while, we go on tour to catch a star. A couple of weeks ago, I locked up the room and headed to Charlotte, North Carolina, to meet with the woman recently named the most powerful figure in showbiz. Ladies and gentlemen, an audience with Britney Spears.
What is different with the Dream Within a Dream tour? It seems to be much more daring than your previous tours.
This is my third tour, and I had a lot of involvement with this tour, and I got to, you know, choose the dancers, choose like everything. So I think it was a bigger deal for me because it was like my baby and my project. I'm not that innocent. Nobody's telling me just what I wanna. I'm so fed up with people telling me to be.
Now that you are no longer a teenager, are you looking for a more adult audience for your music?
You know what, it's not something that you try to do, just, you know, I'm gonna try to sing to this person or to that person. I just, you know, sing what I'm feeling at the time, and hopefully my fans will, you know, appreciate that and like that.
I spotted you dancing. You made all the girls stare.
You know what, lately I've been really interested in like a lot of hip-hop music. I've been really influenced by that, and so I just, you know, I think I incorporate a lot of that into my music lately. But you know what, it changes every day. Who knows, 6 weeks from now I'll probably be singing rock music. You know, it's just whatever I'm feeling at the moment.
Because actually your new song Boys has a little bit more rap in it, right?
I really love the version that we did on the album, but before I did the video, I was like, I want, you know, the Neptunes are amazing, and I knew that they could come in and do something really different with it and have, like, put a dance break in it here or there. And they did. They took the song and they completely redid it, and it's very cool.
It originally was called Girls, and it was a song we did for Michael Jackson, right? See, I'm giving you some exclusive talk right now. But the song never made it to Michael. He never heard it. And so we changed the lyrics around, and then we offered it to Britney, and she liked it.
Thankfully, they liked it so much, they were able to put it into the Austin Powers movie. So I'm really excited about that, yeah.
How is it shooting for the video with Mike Myers?
It was very cool. I loved it. He is the sweetest guy. And it was really hard for me because the whole time I'm trying to be into character and be really cool. No, it didn't work. You know, I was just like, okay. You know, the set was really refreshing because everyone was laughing, and he was very cool to work with. I'm from NYC.
Aren't you Britney? Which music video did you have most fun filming?
Out of all of my, probably my first one, Baby One More Time, because it was my first video, and, you know, the energy was just, everyone was really nervous the first time, you know, probably that one, yeah.
Do you have a lot of input in the making of your videos?
Yeah, that's the funnest part about, you know, doing a video is you're like, I want to do this. Like, for example, the Overprotective video. That was all of my idea, my creation. It's really cool to watch it back and you're like, ooh, you know. But yeah, you have to. It makes it special.
I heard you had a little oops in your video. Oops, I did it again.
Yes, we did. I was laying on the floor. It's the scene where I'm supposed to be laying down, and the camera's like an overhead shot of me. Well, all of a sudden, the camera just falls on my head, and in the middle of the whole video, it was really kind of bad. But yeah, it was very oops, I did it again video.
What did you do?
I had to go get stitches. The doctor had to come and had to stitch me up. So.
But I heard you went back.
Mm-hmm, yeah, I went back and yeah. Mm-hmm.
Good trooper.
Is the song "I'm Not a Girl, Not Yet a Woman" is that autobiographical?
You know, I think that song was really written for the movie Crossroads, but I can relate to it to a certain extent. Yeah.
I know I get a lot of flack for what I wear and what I say and what I don't say. But I'm not a little girl anymore.
What does it mean to you to be named Forbes' most powerful celebrity?
It is very flattering to be called that. I was like, what? Me? Okay, this is cool. Yeah, I was very happy.
You are known to be an admirer of Madonna, who is a champion at reinventing herself. What is the secret to lasting in the music business?
You know what? I think that there's no real secret. I think you just have to love what you do and just be motivated to do, you know, because I think there's a lot of people that they do it and after a while they're like, okay, I'm gonna do something else. You know, I just love what I do and I think your drive says a lot. I mean, I think it boils down to talent, but I think your drive to be a good person and to, you know, stick to doing what you do.
Britney Spears and her dream within a dream.